Hello, this is Marco Biancolini and I'm pleased to present our study Bioinspired Optimization based on biological grow method and mesh morphing surface sculpting. The study that I have conducted together with my colleague Stefano Porziani at the University of Rome Tor Vergata. This is the outline of my presentation. After a short introduction, I will give you an overview about the theoretical background of radial basis functions and about the biological grow method. Then I will show you how these two methods can be coupled together and how it works for a biological application at tree trunk and how this bio-inspired method can then be used for an industrial application, that is the shape optimization of the Ducati Panigale V4 front wheel support. Optimization is gaining more and more interest because we want to have better performance, lighter part, save resources. Numerical simulation allows to virtually test different configuration. Despite this power, it's very difficult to get to an optimal shape because this operation can be time consuming and an automation it is highly desirable to get there. Mesh morphing is an innovative technique that allows to update the shape of your CAE model, in this case an FEAE model, so that shape variation can be quickly explored. The new shape we want with mesh morphing can be computed in an automatic way with the so-called parameterless methods. The biological grow method that is inspired to the way in which natural tissue react to surface load, it's a good way, as I will demonstrate in this study, to have algorithms to reduce the stress and improve the shape of mechanical parts. The methodology that is presented today is implemented within the commercial software ANSYS Mechanical with the mesh morphing tool RBF Morph. We use radial basis function to do mesh morphing. This is a technique that allows to interpolate a function that is known at a certain number of points known as source points. Such interpolation becomes a closed form equation like this. Propagated to receiving points. In this example, we see that we have a fixed point on the square, two points in the middle, one go up, one goes down, and on the right you can see the effect of this information on the inner points, so on the surface that is smoothed by propagating this radial basis function action. When we evaluate the RBF at source point, we know what is the value because it's the input that we put. If we add also the constraints conditions of the polynomial, we get a linear system that need to be solved to compute the coefficients of the radial basis. If we do this for the three direction, this is a three-dimensional field, we implement mesh morphing. As you can see in this equation, the three components of the displacement, Sx, Sy, and Sz, are individually interpolated starting from the information at source points. The behavior of the function in locations that are in the middle, so the kind of interpolation you get, depends on the radial function that you adopt here. The radial function can be global supported, local supported, and a table of typical radial basis function adopted is here presented in this slide. This is the background of the biological grow method. The biological grow method has been observed in different biological structure, so it happens for tree trunks, for bones, for mushroom. And in this example, we can see how twin trunk configuration reacts to a new arrangement And by cutting the tree, you can see in this study by Matek, the layer that grow, the layers that grow, and you can see using FEA, in this case a 2D study, that there is a specific mechanism and that what is typical is that the tissue reacts to the stress. So where the stress is higher, an higher growth is promoted. The formula proposed by Matek for the biological growth method is this one. So the speed of volumetric growth is proportional to the stress, in this case the Fomice stress, computed with respect to a certain reference value. We extended this approach for automatic shape sculpting parameterless by considering different possible stress types. So not only the Fomice, but also the maximum principal stress, the plastic strain, and typically the stress quantity that are used for the design purposes of a specific component. The growth we will have locally will be related to the range of the stress we have in that area, the stress we have at a certain nodes, and a threshold value that we define. The threshold means that we can not only grow, but in some area where the stress is low, we can remove the material, so get a lightening of the part. Here you can see the workflow we are using to couple radial basis function and biological growth method. We first set up the baseline analysis, we get stress on surfaces, and the user defines what is the threshold and what is the allowed growth for the surface set. We compute the displacement that are related. We use these as source points, and if needed, we can add further surface point or source points to have constraints, so to keep fixed some part. And altogether, this is the RBF problem with all the sources. The RBF linear system is solved, and then this field is applied to the wall mesh that is morphed, and so a new solution can be evaluated. Once this is done, a further step can be conducted. So the new shape will have a different stress. And so we have to refresh the displacement because we will have a new stress map. We can use two different strategies for updating the shape. We can move along the local normal of the surface, or we can keep the normal equal to the original one. The first application presented is a biological one, and this is the study presented by Matek in 1990. And in the past, Matek did this study using simple 2D. We are now in 2020, so we decided to face the same study, the same biological observation, doing this with 3D. So to do this, we created for a tree trunk the complex structure, considering that the material we have is not isotropic, but is indeed transverse isotropic because we have the fibers. So using these set, we computed the stress and we computed the area where the stress is higher. Then, implementing the mesh morphing coupled with the biological method, we studied how the shape of this tree trunk surface evolved, and we applied 40 iterations. You can see in this chart that the maximum Fomice stress that starts 12 in the hot spot go down close to B4, and that also the average Fomice stress is reduced during the simulation, getting 60% less for the peak and 44% less for the mean stress. In this slide, you can see on the left the arrangement of the source point in the blue position, in the red position, so you can see the displacement computed in a single step. And on the right, you can see the evolution as computed during the 40 step. You can see that there is a slight shape modification that material is added at the hotspot location. The same animation here is conducted, keeping the same color map for the hotspot, and it is really amazing to see how the nature works, because the hotspot is almost automatically cancelled during the evolution of the shape. Now let's see how this method can be applied for industrial application. In the specific, we have considered a motorsport application, and it's about the Ducati Panigale V4. In particular, we focus on the front wheel hub that is very highly stressed. And it's a very important point because it connects the wheel with the front suspension, with the brake. It is made with an aluminium alloy. Not all the data are given because of confidentiality. Here you can see the shape of the part considered and the boundary conditions, so the load to the braking and the constraints, and the original map of the stress. Two hot spot area are identified, and we considered three different approach. So we considered the case in which the setup of the two hot spot is studied with a separate optimization, and another in which we use the BGM at the same time for both the surface. Here we have the result. We used in this case 10 iterations, and we can see the result of the first approach, the second approach, and the third one. For all the situation, we can see that there is some benefit. The first setup will give you a reduced volume, but more or less you get the same stress. With the second approach, there is a small increase of the volume and a 16% lower stress. With the third approach, that is the best as far as hotspot mitigation, we get 20% stress less. Here you can see the result. So the best result, that is the setup number 3, we can see the final stress distribution and the final shape. I conclude my presentation summarizing that a parameterless approach for shape optimization has been introduced. It works by combining the biological grow method and mesh morphing, and it works at hotspot, and the new shape is driven by the stress intensity. This is something that mimics the grow mechanism that we observe in natural tissue. And we first considered to reproduce a biological application, the tree trunk shape evolution presented by Matek 30 years ago. We use a complete three-dimensional study with a good agreement. Then we move to a second application that was about the optimization of a motorbike part. In this case, we experimented three different setup option for the optimization workflow, and in the one that we consider the best, we get a reduction of 20% of the maximum equivalent. Before concluding, let me express our gratitude to the Motocorse San Marino that shared the geometry, the part, and the problem with us, and to Andrea Ridolfi that supported the technical activities. Many thanks for your kind attention.